College is not free. College is very expensive. And we'll get into scholarships in just a second. But the cost of college tuition includes your room and board. That's your dormitory fees. Your meal plan, just like how the cafeteria you come in and you get your food, there's a meal plan option at college. Your books are free here at high school, but when you go to college, you've got to pay for your books or rent your books. And then health insurance and IT. You guys are covered by your parents' health insurance, whether it's Medicaid, Medicare, private health insurance. But in college, since you're an adult, you have an option to purchase health insurance through the college, or you can use your parents' health insurance when you go to school. IT fees, just like how you go upstairs and you can go to the library and go in and use the computer and print everything out, and it's free. Well, in college, someone has to pay for that Wi-Fi, that ink, that printer, those copies, right? That's a portion of your tuition. Yes, sir.
What happened?
It's your personal option, and that's a parent's adult decision to make whether you'll stay on their insurance or you'll take the school's option. So that's kind of a personal preference, but just as long as you're covered legally. And did you guys hear his question? His question was, do you use the college's insurance or do you use your parents? And that's a conversation that he has to have with his parent to see what's best economical for your family. Okay? All right, and then there's college application fees. There's something called a waiver. If you receive free and or reduced lunch, your counselor has waiver forms. That means that if your college application fee is $40, and if you receive free and or reduced lunch, you can go to your counselor to ask for a waiver. It's on a first come, first served basis, depending on your school. And this is an example of a waiver. But sometimes your school won't make you fill this out. They'll just give you the number. You also can get a waiver for your SAT and ACT to take those tests as well. Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. Did you guys hear her? If you go to at some college fairs, if you go, they'll waive that application fee for you. For that particular day. Thanks for sharing. They also have something called commitment and housing deposits. How many of y'all have heard of layaway? Okay. So what commitment deposits and housing deposits is similar to layaway. Say for instance that you have a $10,000 bill at college and you say, on May 1st, I'm a senior, I'm committing to your school. Well, your college, some colleges will say, well, put something on it then. You're coming to our school, say it in money. So some commitment, I know UGA has a commitment deposit fee where they'll say, well, you'll have to put X amount of dollars towards your $10,000 balance. Regardless if you have FAFSA or you're paying in cash, they like a financial commitment and you talk to the school for details. A housing deposit, again, they ask you to put down some money, like a layaway payment, for your housing. So if you're staying on campus to reserve your dorm bed in that dorm, you may have to put down a financial commitment. Yes, sir. It's also called a commitment fee. Yes, thank you for sharing. Commitment fees or acceptance fees, those are the same. Those are deposits. Yes, same words. Does someone else have a question? These are great questions. I like when you guys stop when you have questions about something. So now you guys know what tuition, application fees, and deposits are. Kiss your brain. All right, number four. High school counselor and school evaluation. How many of you all know the name of your counselor? Raise your hand. Keep your hands raised if you can answer this question. How many of you all have seen your counselor since January? Keep your hand raised.
Yes.
Awesome. You put your hands down. There
Y'all
are three
that.
People that help you get to college. Who's number one?
Parents.
Your parents. Who's number two?
You.
Who's number three?
Counselor.
You're a counselor. This is one of the most important relationships that you need to maintain. You don't go to your counselor for them to fix something. You need to have and make a develop a relationship with your counselor because they help you get into school. I'm going to tell you a true example. My brother's best friend. Her name is Lane, and she had applied to go to Columbia, New York, and Howard University in Washington, D.C. She submitted her information to her counselor as far as what she needed to do for her transfer and gave her the deadlines and everything. Lane did her part, submitted it to the counselor, had a great relationship with her counselor, submitted the information, went on about her life. When it was time to hear back from colleges, everybody was hearing back from their school of choice. She didn't hear back from Columbia or Howard. She picked up the phone and she called Howard. Columbia. When she called Columbia, they said, "Well, yes, Lane, we got your initial transcript and information, but we did not get your last transcript that we requested. Thank you for applying. You've missed the deadline. If you want to apply next year, and we'll take your college application fee. Thank you for applying. You will not be accepted as a freshman. You met all the requirements except the transcript. Thanks for applying." Hung up the phone. Lane was salty. She ran back to her counselor and was like, counselor, I did what I was supposed to do. I sent in the information. I gave you the deadline. The counselor went to her desk, a stack full of paper, and said, oops, my bad, it was here. Now, every time I tell that story, everybody was like, oh, that counselor messed up. No, people are human. Mistakes happen. However, and sometimes emails don't receive their final destination. Sometimes mail does not get to the final location. However, it was Lane's responsibility as a young adult to go back to that counselor to make sure that her transcript was submitted. Because again, accidents happen, things happen. It's your responsibility if you hand off something to your counselor or you hand your college essay off to your teacher and you ask them to review it, it's your responsibility to follow up with them to make sure that they have everything that they need or that they did what you asked them to do. People are human, people make mistakes. So you guys are young adults, and that's the culture that you have to develop going into college, is that your professors are not going to run behind you to make sure that you've done something or to make sure that they did something for you. It's your responsibility to make sure that you circle back with your professor and build that relationship, just like how you're practicing building your relationship with your counselor. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay.